हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू क्रिएटिव मेडिसिन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट
राइट। सो व्हेनेवर देयर इज पेप्टिक अल्सर, परफोरेटेड पेप्टिक अल्सर ट्रीटमेंट और मैनेजमेंट ऑफ परफोरेटेड पेप्टिक अल्सर्स। सो फॉर द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ परफोरेटेड पेप्टिक अल्सर, हियर वन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज द पेशेंट विल बी अनस्टेबल। सो यू शुड फर्स्ट डू नेसोगैस्ट्रिक एस्पिरेशन आर डन टू द पेशेंट। Analgesia is given to the patient because the patient will have pain, and because there is increased risk of bacterial peritonitis is seen in the peptic ulcer perforation. So as a result, we have to give antibiotics and analgesics are given along with the patient is also resuscitated with isotonic fluids and with anti-secretory agents. The patient is resuscitated. And then in the patient with perforated peptic ulcers, surgery is almost always indicated in a patient with perforated peptic ulcers. Surgery is always indicated in patient with perforated peptic ulcer. Perforation should be, sometimes it is sealed spontaneously. Sometimes perforation has sealed spontaneously by the time of presentation. By the time the patient presents itself, the perforation might have sealed spontaneously. If the perforation is sealed spontaneously and if the patient is stable and he is okay, he is stable and fine, in that case surgery can be avoided. But except in this case, in every case surgery is always indicated in a patient with a perforated peptic ulcer. Second, then if the surgery can be avoided in this case, what is the non-operative management that can be given to the patient, or when do you give non-operative management? Actually, this non-operative management is actually given whenever the patient has the following. One, whenever the patient has no leak on the radiological study, or if the patient has no chemical peritonitis. That means whenever there is no evidence that the leak has occurred, when there is an evidence that the leak has sealed, because whenever the perforation is sealed, then obviously the patient is stable, perforation is sealed, everything is normal, you do not need to do surgery. So a non-operative management is done if the leak has been sealed through a radiologic contrast study. Second, if there is no chemical peritonitis, clinical peritonitis is not present. In both these cases, we can do an operative management of the patient is not necessary. In both these cases, we can do a non-operative management.
Thank you, and thank you for watching.